you so much, Rita. Let me take this opportunity to invite Bonachege Dombe to make a few remarks as a member of the group. Thank you, Chege.
For me, a time like now, just like we have heard the word, when you have a date when you are born is a date when you die. And when you look at even the scriptures, everyone from creation, there was a time, even those who lived for many years at the beginning, there was a time they came, lived, enjoyed themselves, and eventually they died. And in every situation, they were mourned. Even this morning, we mourn a father for us at the family of Obsidian Bank, to us, a mentor, a true patriot, a visionary leader, an entrepreneur, an investor, and also someone who loved to support the community. The bank has lost a great leader, a person that we all admired, and we'll continue to remember him. He has left a strong legacy individually as also as a bank. So today we celebrate the life of Dr. Chris Kirubi, who has impacted many of us in different ways, just like the previous speakers have talked about. And we believe that he has done great things at personal level, at corporate level, as a country, in the country. And we stand with the family to celebrate his life, together with the family members, friends, colleagues, and especially the entire group, Centum, whom he has been part and parcel of each one of us and the lives for many of us for many years. Dr. Kirubi has been also part of us in the Obsidian Bank family for a long time, not only as a long-serving director of the Centum, who are the majority shareholders of the bank, but also as a very great customer, who for many years he valued and told us the importance of customer service, the importance of relationships, the importance of looking into the future more than the short-term goals of any business. And he shared a cordial relationship as an investor, as a customer, and supported us in many, many, many ways. And individually, through his various businesses, he continue to support us, and we'll remember him, and we'll always remember the years that he was with us. Many of us attest Dr. Kirubi's distinct passion for entrepreneurship and selfless mentorship that he has provided, either individually through personal interactions or through different forums, or even in many years when he has participated in the media or the socially, or even the social media or other forms, where he has been an advocate for hard work, like we have also been told this morning, where he was a great entrepreneur, where he focused on creativity, innovation, and inspired many people to focus on building sustainable businesses. We as a bank, we enjoyed his support, and we still remember the support that he's given us, where the core mission of the bank has been to support entrepreneurs in the country. Personally, myself, I met him way back in 2022. He came there through Capital FM to support us launching a new product that we were supporting in that bank at the time. And he came himself as a person to tell us support us on how we can launch this product for the upcoming young people, middle class, using technology. Digital is the way to go, and digital will be the future. And today we know, all of us, we no longer carry paper, we do our banking transactions, social media is on the digital services, gadgets. And at that time, we had not seen it the way it is going today. And he was very, very supportive to us as a bank then. When I joined 2017 as a CEO of Obsidian Bank, was new to the group. I had not known him much more other than the early interaction. And he called me one afternoon and told me, Chege, just tell me when you are available and come, we have a cup of tea. And I went to his office and we discussed about many, many things. And one of the things that I remember him encouraging me is what we can do to transform the bank. And today I can attest that 3-4 years down the road, we've been able to transform the bank significantly. It has grown significantly to be a very different institution down the road. So Kirubi has been an inspiration to me as a person and even to my colleagues. And we're grateful for that opportunity that we have had spent with him. Sometime back when in fell ill in 2019, again through a phone call, we were able to connect and continue conversing and having a conversation. And he invited me to his house where we spent some time, straight over 2.5 hours, talking about his vision for the country, his vision for the youth, his vision for the group companies that he, the impact that he was making to many of us in his businesses. And what I recall from that moment is a moment that he also talked about God. And we had a moment to thank God for his life, for the great achievements that he have had for his family, and for God giving him the years he had given him to live, to enjoy, and to make an impact to many of us and to many people in this life. And we had a moment to pray together and to thank God together for this work that he has been in this world. During the same time, he also appreciated the family around him, his immediate family, of course, his children, grandchildren, and more important also the family of the businesses that he was in, the Centrum Group and other companies that he supported. Those were his family. So on behalf of CDN Bank, I bring my condolences, even as we celebrate his life, to Robert, to Melian, the children, and even to the siblings and the entire family of Centrum, the bank, and all the other groups that companies that he was associated with, and to for this morning and the days ahead, that God may continue to encourage them, to heal them, and to give them strength even as they go through this phase. So our thoughts and our prayers are with the family at this time, and we pray for God to give them joy, to give them peace, to give them comfort in the days ahead. And in conclusion, for me, I'll look at the scriptures in the book of 2 Corinthians, verses Corinthians 1, 3, and 4, which tells us, blessed be the God and the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of mercies, and the God of all comfort, who comforts us in all affliction, so that we may be able to comfort those who are in affliction with the comfort with which we ourselves are comforted by God. Thank you, and God bless you.